My name is Yoke Shayoki. I know a lot of you guys here. This is our engineer, Lee. He's also our project manager. And when I mean project manager, I mean this man can help you with really large scale projects. For example, we recently did a college. I'm not allowed to disclose which one. It's a very popular college. A lot of you guys might even be fans of their football team. But Lee here, he actually helped our customer from the beginning, designing the project. Even during, he built the servers. Not only did he build them, but he programmed them and hand-delivered them to our clients. And that's the kind of support that we provide for our clients here at SavvyTech. So if you guys ever have a really big project where you guys need some help, you know, feel free to ask. That's what we're here for. We're very customer service oriented. We're gonna do a presentation for an hour, but I'm sure you guys have a lot of things to do, and you know, we're just gonna cut it short so we can have more time for the Q&A. I encourage each and every one of you guys to ask whatever you guys need to ask. Our goal here today is for all of you guys to leave with no question unanswered. So that's our goal here today. I encourage all of you guys to interact with us after we're done with the presentation. You guys can come up and take a look at our live demo. If you guys have any questions about it, like I said, my engineer's here. I'm here. We'll answer all of your questions for you guys. So let's imagine a security system for your home or business where it's powerful enough to integrate your security cameras, your recorder, your access control, your video intercom, and even your alarm. Well, I'm very excited to announce our newest product line that can take care of all of that for you. Not only can you integrate it, but it's easy to install, and it's also very simple to program. I know a lot of you guys here are very experienced. I'm sure you guys won't have any problems with none of this. Here's a simple diagram of our access control. As you can see here, when I mean simplicity, I mean it's as simple as this diagram is here. You have your outdoor intercom, and you run your Cat5 to your PoE, your central PoE controller. And from that point, you connect that to your router, and obviously to your internet so you can get your live view. On this diagram, we have a camera here, but there's no recorder, so this is just doing a live view. So when you go to your monitor, you can actually access the cameras without you having to go into the DVR or in this case, you don't have a DVR, but that's how this is set up. If you did have a DVR, then you'd be able to do playback, and you'd be able to put it all in one system and run it all through the app. So here's a live demo. And when you first hit the doorbell camera, it will call your monitor, or if you're not at home, it's going to call your cell phone. And from that point on, you will engage in a two-way audio, one-way video conversation. And if you even needed to open a door from a remote location, the system is actually powerful enough to do so. So let's say you're in the Bahamas with your wife or your husband, and your kids lost their keys. All they have to do is ring the doorbell. You'll go ahead and open the door, and simple as that. Here's another diagram using our video intercom in a commercial application. So right here you have multiple levels with multiple intercoms. So when your guests arrive at the door, they can dial whatever suite you're in. It'll go straight to the monitor, and from that point on, you can choose to unlock the door. You can choose to come down, greet your client, bring them upstairs. Oh, and up here, you see that you have the recorder and your camera, so this would be like an administrative office, so they have all that, but everything will be integrated at this point. Moving on to our access control. Here's a simple diagram of how simple it is to install. I mean, it's as simple as the diagram is showing. You have your door magnet locks, your reader, and even your alarm connected to one controller. Everything is controlled by the software. So if you want to give certain people access to a certain spot, or if you want to give this person very restricted access. Everything is programmable through our software. Here's a live demo of our access control. You can either choose three different kinds of access points. We have an RF card reader. You have your keypad combination with the RF card reader, and you have your biometric access point. So you can choose what kind of access points you guys want, or whatever your clients want, and integrate it all together. Our access control actually, it's not just for small projects. It can be done for large scale projects. So each one of these controllers, each one of these systems can have a total of 500 controllers total. So that tells you right there, you know, we're not just small projects, we can do this for big projects too. All with ease of mind, with a lot of simplicity. It doesn't take an engineer to do this, anyone can do this. And I'm sure all you guys are highly experienced. This would be a piece of cake for you guys.
How many readers for controller you can have?
You can have a total of
2,000 controllers? No, not for each controller. It's for a whole system, maximum is 500 controllers. So total, each controller can connect to 4 readers.
4 readers?
Yeah, 4 readers.
I'm sorry, I was actually supposed to ask you guys on the video intercom. Do you guys have any questions about this? There's no question that's too little or too technical. I mean, you know, like I said, our goal here is to make sure that each and every one of you guys leave here today. Yes, sir.
Under the one app that we download right now, are we going to get the cameras, the intercom?
Absolutely. Thank you for bringing that up, Mario. Actually, that's the beauty of the system. There's plenty of doorbell manufacturers out there, but what sets SavvyTech apart from everybody is two main factors. Number one, you can integrate the doorbell camera to your DVR to be a continuous recording channel. So let's say your UPS guy came by and he spit some gum on the floor, he left your package, you come home and you step on it. If you had any of those other doorbells, you wouldn't even know. You wouldn't be able to see. With ours, you'll be able to see when that person first came to your porch all the way to where he hit your doorbell, and you'll be able to get all that footage on the playback from your DVR. And on that same app, you can do your playback at any time as well.
And on that same app, he could even think that I'm in the house, because if he rings the doorbell, I can get it to come up on my app.
Absolutely.
I'll come in and say, I'm not available right now. Leave it at the door, and he'll never know when I was there or if I was off site.
Mm-hmm. So thank you for bringing that up too. So if you guys are familiar with our product right now, if you use the app, in the beginning of the app, you have three options. You have your camera for your live view. You have your doorbell camera icon, and then you have your alarm. So you have three functions on there. So, go ahead.
Is there a limit to how many devices you could download the app to and access it from different, like for instance, if you have a tablet, or if you have a phone, or if you have other people that have access to it, or is there just one?
I think the total is 120 users.
Yeah,
120 users.
Yeah.
And then the limit actually is the limit is by your networking. If your network is slow, maybe two user
will get notification.
Got the footage. But if you like the gigabyte networking, connect to the DVR or the internet system, that will be 100% same time online.
And turn off certain people
Absolutely.
From accessing that app?
Yeah, not only that.
Certain times of the day or whatever?
Exactly. And not only that, but you can actually choose what channel this person's able to access. Mm-hmm. You know, it's fully customizable.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
On the cameras, is it IP cameras, CVI, both?
That's the beauty of our system. It works with both.
Okay.
Matter of fact, if you're using our new coax, our 5-in-1 Pentabrid, mm-hmm. that one gives you additional channels of IP.
Okay.
So instead of you using your BNC like it was before, where it's all overall, you don't touch your BNCs, you can use additional.
You can use the IP, and then the IP.
Exactly.
On top of that.
And that's perfect for our systems, because these are actually PoE based. So it's a match made in heaven, basically. You don't sacrifice your BNCs, you run it all through one app. And back to the app, So there's two portions, like I said, there's a doorbell and then there's the camera. So when you integrate the doorbell to your recorder, then you can do a live view and you can do a playback. But when they hit the doorbell, that's gonna use the doorbell camera portion of it. See, as you can see here, they just show, this is actually, this is one of the doorbell cameras. It's on.
Did you just push it?
Yeah, that one is by network. Just like as a IP camera to the.
I have a good question. You ready for this one?
I'm ready.
This is gonna be a good one. The DSS. So right now I have a big department that I took over, and I'm running a full automated DSS, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to put the access control on that station that I'm at. I have about 20 doors I gotta do. Mm-hmm. Can I interact with the DSS client?
Yeah. Yeah. These clients use that tool.
You know why? Because I mean, I'd rather go this route than hybrid something else on it. You know what I mean?
Right.
And if I can interact with that, I'm in total control right here.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
The intercom camera is recording.
It's recording. Yeah. So back to what I was saying earlier. So right now, if you want to access it for a live view, then you would use the camera portion, not the doorbell on your app.
Of course.
And when you do that, then you can do a live view. Now, when they hit the doorbell, now it's going to use the other portion of that. It's still in the same app, but it's going to use the doorbell function. So it's gonna call your cell phone. It's gonna, here's actually a live, another live demo here. So they're gonna call you, and it's gonna go through that portion of the app, the doorbell, and then you'll be able to do what Lee did earlier. You'll be able to unlock the door.
Via the network, right?
Exactly. And it's all, and it all works with one app. So back then, you know, you had your certain brands. You had like 10 brands to do what you can do with only one brand here. And that's the beauty of it.
What recording options can you do on the intercom camera?
As a standalone.
Yeah, the standalone.
What do you mean, like
motion?
Like motion?
Schedule,
yeah.
You can do
well, the motion's actually from the DVR itself.
Okay.
So any camera that you plug in will support
what
the motion.
What if I do this directly without a DVR?
At that point, I don't think it will.
Okay, if without a DVR, the intercom camera just recording like the video message, someone will be read the video message if you don't answer the phone. And also, someone push the button and no one answer, like you said, just let set the 15 seconds, and then after that will auto capture 3 pictures from the camera. So, and the indoor unit, you just put the SD card inside, so we'll be like recording the video message, audio message, also the audio capture the picture. Just like I got some information, some guest message here. You just show picture. That's because I pushed that before, right? No one answered, so 3. Image get auto captures here. Yeah, just by the unit without DVR.
So just images from standalone.
Yeah.
And messages. So if you ring doorbell, nobody answers, then you can set it to where it takes a message.
Like a voice message?
Like a voice message. So you can say, hey, I came by and you weren't here, give me a call when you get home.
Yeah.
You know.
Just like you just set the answer time by yourself. I set as 15 seconds. After that there will okay, I leave the message, push the button, and then you recording, looking at the message, something, finish, you push the button again, the message completed. So after you go home, you check the message here, guest message, okay, that one's guest message, video message.
So that's another feature that sets us apart from, you know, other doorbell manufacturers. So that's a way of SavvyTech showing you guys how we bring a lot more bang for your buck.
So how long does it keep the recording? How long does it record? One day, 2 days? How much data is it?
The data depends on the SD card.
It's a total of 128 gigabytes, so whatever fits in that.
External memory, right?
Yeah.
External memory.
Yeah, it's an SD.
So it depends on the memory you.
Yeah.
Well, this one only supports 128, so even if you get like a 256, it's only that.
And if it's full, does it keep on writing it? Or?
It does, right?
That one will be like the message.
Because you need to know the message. Right. Because
you have
a question? Yeah. Sure. Mm-hmm. President, DDR,
Can you
record to the cloud? And number two, on the alarm console here, it's wired. Do you have a version that's wireless?
At the time, we don't. We're
if you're doing a retrofit, running the wires for existing buildings, it's a major job.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, we are actually going to have a few units that are wireless in the future. We just haven't. Okay. They're not there yet.
What about the DVR, the recording?
So as far as the recording to cloud, our DVRs and our NVRs are compatible. All you would have to do is set an FTP. So it's either, yeah, and they're both.
It doesn't go to OneDrive or Google Drive or anything or Magic. Does it have to set up already?
No, yeah, you would have to set it up.
Set the FTP file.
You can say, for example, go to Google Drive, just leave the name and password, or you have to use FTP.
Actually, Google Drive, you just change to the FTP.
You have to go to the FTP.
Yeah, Google Drive is set to FTP, it's okay. And also the Dropbox has the FTP service. So, but you need to check the port, which port you need, and which IP you need, and input your username and password, and then just like the simple FTP login. Also, the intercom has the FTP function too. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We don't have a tutorial right now. Yeah, we're gonna work on a tutorial on that soon. Yes, sir.
Your readers, is it proprietary to your access panel, or will it take any Wigand input from any reader?
As long as it's an RF.
It means the
access.
Like a lot of the panels we deal with, they'll take anybody's reader as long as it's got a Wigand format feeding out the signals to the control panel. So if we want to use your readers, or we want to use any ID readers or anybody else's readers, we can't. Or you can't do that.
Oh, you mean the RF card?
The reader itself.
Oh, the reader?
Yeah.
The card reader.
Yeah. Actually, if you issue the RF card for the device, that one is carried just like a card reader. So you don't.
No, what I'm
to
saying is, if I want to use somebody else's reader, can I use it on your panel, or do I gotta buy your readers and use them with your panel?
If you use the reader like the USB reader, connect to the computer. And use the software will be.
Do you get what I'm saying?
No, I think he's.
What's the protocol that you read up?
I think that's. You're asking if we have a different manufacturer.
Yeah, format of the reader.
Different
asking.
Reader format.
He's asking if you're universal.
Reader format. That one is a Wigand. It's Wigand by the standard.
Yeah, it'll accept the needless signal.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Wigand, that one is a standard Wigand. And also the 485. 36, 24, yeah, also okay. Just by setting in the system.
On the panel, the software is included on.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
So it's open architecture, no restricted licenses or any of that stuff.
Exactly.
It's an open platform.
Exactly. Even on our IP cameras.
Do your control panels have any kind of? Because we do a lot of government work, so. You gotta have a certificate of networthiness and all these stuff to run on like DoD networks or Navy networks. Are you certified for any of that stuff at this point?
I think at this time we're not. I think if you do, if you're doing government jobs, the equipment has to be part of the Free Trade Act, and I don't think at this time we get certified for that. So.
Okay. Just curious. Mm-hmm.
On your controller, to control the locks, is it 12 volt DC?
12 volt, yeah.
Do you have 24?
24 and 12 volt.
You have both?
Yeah, both. Actually, they control the routers by the NCN and COM, the connection. So the NCN COM, the connection, and also the power just by the rock.
Right.
It's not just not here to output. Also, the panel output the power too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any other questions on our video?
You say it's the software is configurable for all kinds of settings. Where does that software reside? Is that your cloud software, or is that in DVR? Is it in the panel?
Well, you could you could either download it. We could always send you a download link, but I think it should come with the disk. It's using Smart PSS.
Okay, so it's an application that you have on your computer that you push settings to the device.
Yes.
And then you leave it alone.
Exactly.
So
and you
it's not something that's always connected to the.
No need to always connect to.
Okay.
They will be working by itself. And also, just like video intercom, like some business or the apartment, they have the security office there. Someone just walking the mall.
Yeah.
And if you're running the software, that will be connected to the monitor.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very easy to configure and do the open the software. Yeah.
This is perfect, right? So this is actually, the platform is easy now. So you just mentioned PSS.
Mm-hmm.
That blows everybody away. This is on there?
Yeah.
Wow.
All of it. So when you want to configure who has access to what, you want to configure cameras, you want to configure access.
It's all there.
It's all in one app. Yeah, and like I said earlier, that's the beauty of it. That's
right.
That's what makes it a lot more versatile.
Well, that's
absolutely.
On your DVR, I'm assuming it's a cloud access, right?
Yeah.
So is it peer-to-peer, or is it used a third-party service, right?
You mean a peer-to-peer service?
Yeah, I mean, if you want to communicate with the panel or the DVR, are you going to your application, does it go peer-to-peer, or is it to a third-party service?
Do the P2P, or just do the external IP? Direct IP.
Okay.
Yeah, direct IP or P2P. If P2P server, we use the Amazon server,
okay.
So it's very stable, and also the server,
and
also the servers in the US, it's not like some manufacturer, the server in China or in India or something, they just in the US, so it's very stable server.
So we can make changes to who has access and who doesn't have access remotely.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Remotely for your cameras, remotely, or even for your access control, who can go where.
So that's still done through software that's
yeah.
on your computer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You just don't have to be on the local network. So these devices have a serial number, they're going out to the cloud, and then your laptop or whatever is connecting to the cloud at the same time.
That one just, when you're setting, you just connect it there. If you don't need, you already setting done? Okay, no need to configure anymore.
Is it
going
on the Mac?
Yeah.
Yes. It's compatible with Mac, PC.
How often do you have to update the software? Or is it auto update? Any changes, you know, any versions or whatever?
You mean the version upgrade?
Yeah.
That one will be like the 2 months something, but just depends on the new product. New product, right? If the release a new product and need to new function,
mm-hmm.
that will be upgrade the software, also the app. The same app for the camera, video intercom, and also the app for iPhone, Android phone, Windows phone. So it's they will be upgrade same. At the same time.
Can you talk a little bit about what kind of reports we get out of the access? What reports we get out of the access control?
The access will be export like the CSV file.
What's in the report? What do you get?
It's basically whatever you need. So if you want to know, you know, what this person, where this person's been going throughout your whole facility.
So you
get
know. The in and out.
Yeah, in and out,
times,
yeah,
location,
times,
yeah.
Does it
control egress and in and out? Can you put one in, one out to egress?
Yeah, one in, one out, and multiple paths, and then anti-pass, and interlock.
Okay.
I was talking about the setting.
How many events does it store?
The events is like 1,000 events.
1,000?
1,000 events, but the parallel for the daily, just four. Four parallel for one day, the same day, just four setting.
For what? I'm sorry, I didn't get that. For what?
For the event.
For the event?
For, only four types of events per day.
A 1,000 occurrences.
Yeah, you're setting 1,000, but you just four per day.
Okay. And can you get the report like by door, by name?
Yeah.
Let's say if you want this person, which door he used.
Yeah.
Or if you want a door, see who used that door.
Yeah.
The report.
Yeah, you just
like
you're just setting the user eyes. Yeah.
For larger houses, using something like this, does it have a RCA out for audio to be integrated with like in ceiling speakers there throughout the house or something?
Well, you could integrate audio to the DVR, and then DVR you can integrate everything else.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So chances are in a big house I'm going to be using the DVR anyways, and so just the audio outputs from the DVR to an amplifier. And
mm-hmm. Sorry. Okay.
But these, just without the DVR, they don't have an audio output from these.
I'm sorry, say that again.
Just this stuff alone without the DVR doesn't have an audio output.
I don't believe these have audio outputs, no. Anybody else have any questions?
Integrating the system with automatic gate systems, things like that, is there any problems with that at all? Like with either Door King or Elite or any of the gate operating systems? And can you intercom out
you must have get integrated
the,
with
the
like
integration?
Okay. I mean,
yeah. Like let's say that when you go into an apartment, they have one.
Yeah.
And it's fully compatible.
Yeah, fully compatible. Compatible all the electric gate,
yeah.
Light gate, doors, and the magnet and the door strip. Yeah.
So you could integrate different facilities, even if they're not in proximity to each other.
Exactly.
Let's say one customer has offices in one area. And then in one block or whatever, and he has another one, you can still integrate it?
Absolutely. Okay. Matter of fact, you can actually put one of these monitors here, and you can have that monitor in a remote location. And when they hit the doorbell, it's going to go to that monitor, and you can do the same functions, let them in. You know, so you know, so to answer your question, yeah, you can.
With one DVR?
With one DVR?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, everything just by IP.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It can be anywhere.
Anywhere, yeah. Pretty much, yeah. Absolutely. And with the smart PSS software, you can actually put a bunch of different DVRs and MVRs together in one. Yeah. Very powerful unit.
Yeah.
And then that software, it's free. That's the best part of all.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
That's like the sister of the DSS.
I was going to ask that.
Yeah.
Oh, no license fee. No download fee, no license fee. 100% free.
Yeah.
Helps you put it on the top of your cell.
Right.
I've been using it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Elevator control.
Since they made it a little
better.
Elevator control. That's all we're given as well.
Yeah.
Do you have a long-range reader? Or like a long-range reader? Do you have also for cars getting into the gate? And then you have a, you know, like a button push.
That one is compatible with the button push.
That was the button.
Yeah.
Like, you know, for the parking lot, when you have a car coming in and you have for the parking.
Mm-hmm. Just like that one?
Long range.
No, he's talking about like a gate controller.
Gate controller, yeah. Just like the gate controller, connect to the controller. Because the gate controller is like the RFID something. So the long range will be connect to the controller. And the controller connect to the lock. Just like push button, the lock will be open.
If you wanted something that's in surface, we do have modules like these right here. We have a 2-module or a 3-module like the one here. These are more for like in a commercial application. You can actually choose what modules you want in there too. So say you want a biometric fingerprint, like the one here, you can use that. You can use the card reader that's on there right now, or the pad, you can type in the code. So it's basically whatever fits your customer best. And here you have your IP switch, your POE switch. I'm sorry, wait, this is a door phone system. And here you have other access points. Like I mentioned earlier, you have your biometric. You have your key in code combination with a RFID card. And you could use a RFID card, or you can use a keychain like this one right here. These have become very popular. A lot of people are using these instead of the card.
The fob.
Yeah, the fob. We carry a variety of door magnet locks, as well as the brackets for it, all the accessories, basically anything you need. We also have exit buttons and infrared exits. We have one of the buttons here for exit door. Lee's going to go over with you guys on a little bit of the technical side of this.
One last question. Sure. Are you manufacturing like any kind of demo kit that you can take out like to a client to demonstrate in a presentation where you put a couple of readers in it, something like that? Are you got any plans to build it?
Absolutely.
Like that?
Actually, thank you for asking that. That's something that we also do here at SavvyTech. If you guys have a client that wants a demo, go ahead and consult with your sales rep. Your sales rep will put a demo together based on whatever you want, an NVR, DVR, access control, we'll put it all together for you, and we'll go out and do the demo with you. We've done that a lot of times, and we've helped a lot of customers close big deals like that. For example, me and Lee did a school. That went very well. Yes, sir?
Would you guys possibly be able to do like a video, per se? Like I have like a customer that was in Washington State or Florida or something like that, you know, and they were interested in this system. They wouldn't be able to fly to Hacienda Heights to see a demo of it. Would, you know, is there a possibility of maybe doing like a interactive YouTube video that you could show them?
We can do that for you too.
Okay.
Actually, what we can do in the case like that, we can bring the demo to you, and then we can do it on your facility and do like a live broadcasting, and that way we can, you know, using Skype or something like that, and then we could do a demo with the equipment along with your client.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, cool.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions? All right, so we're going to move on to the technical side here.
Okay. Emma, for the intercom system and the access control system, both by network. So for networking, very important thing is the IP. So you got to, for the intercom system, we have outdoor unit, indoor unit. So the first thing for that two unit, you need to set the IP first. Okay, very simple. The outdoor unit, just sync the GUI, the interface is synced as the MVR setting or DVR setting here. You just log in, use the web browser to log in to set the outdoor unit. And then indoor unit is touch screen. And very simple. That one is indoor unit. Indoor unit setting here. It's very simple, just by the touch screen. So two, you need to set the IP first. Because the two unit communicate by IP. And just like you say, that one maybe just like the remote location, a different location. So you just set the external IP for the outdoor unit or for indoor unit. So everything you set it, because the indoor unit set the IP and outdoor unit set the IP. That one is for the outdoor unit. The setting is by the indoor unit to communicate to the outdoor unit. So you need to set the outdoor unit and indoor unit first, and then set the communicate by the two unit. And also the important thing is the room number. The room number is a short number, just like you call which room. The monitor you call the, where I called here. the roll number is 101. And then the roll number, why the roll number is important, the roll number need to set to the outdoor unit. Let them communicate by self. Okay. The logging, the outdoor unit log is very simple. Interface is same as the similar as the MVR, DVR here. So, okay, here the indoor unit.
Yep.
So that long number is the outdoor unit, it's the indoor unit's long number. It's when after you set all the same, they will communicate by itself. And then also you will show on here already communicate, two unit already communicate.
The master talking to client.
Yeah. The master not talking to client. The master is talking like, just like you have the phone monitor. Actually, one outdoor unit support phone monitor. The phone monitor should be one master, four extension. Here. So one outdoor unit, four monitor, five monitor, one master, four extension. And the extension setting just same as the master setting. So just like you just set one monitor here, set a master monitor, and then another extension monitor connect to the master monitor by the IP, master IP. And then that's it. You don't need to set anything. The same time raining. So that one is master, that one is extension.
So for instance, you have like a four-unit apartment complex, and the four masters are talking to the one access panel, and
yeah,
then within each apartment you can have four extensions,
yeah,
in different rooms. Is,
yeah,
that kind of what you're talking,
yeah,
about?
Just like apartment complex, use that one, and you just set the four unit, four master,
yeah,
and then another. Each unit, another four extension.
Right.
So actually, each master connect 20 doors. So like the apartment complex, one maybe is front door and rear door, and back door and side door and yard.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 20 doors.
Okay.
Yeah.
When you set your IP addresses, can you put it on the HTTP or does it have to be static?
Has to be started because they communicate by IP. If you put on the DHCP, sometimes will be changed.
Right.
If changed, you cannot communicate together. And also, the indoor unit, you could set the IPC by the networking. That one is I setting is for the DVR. So need to set a port and channel, which channel from the DVR, from the MVR. And also, if you without that one, you still view the IPC, but no recording. Just like here, I will view the, maybe it's a little bit small. That's channel one. That one's channel one from the DVR. It's the IPC here. So you just set like the remote location, like you're at home, but you set the monitor connect to your office IPC or DVR or MVR, no matter where's the camera, maybe in another country, just by IP. But the camera, you need to do the porting for that thing. And also for the apartment complex, we got another solution for upgrade the old system, like the docking. The docking system is a 4-wire. They use 4-wire to connect the old school the dock. But we got another solution. Use two pin to upgrade that one. It's by 2-wire VTH and 2-wire VTO. Outdoor unit and the indoor unit just by 2-wire. So if the like the existing apartment company already got already have system, but they went to upgrade, and you don't need to learn the cable, learn the Cat5 cable. If for the IP system, you need to learn the Cat5 cable, right? But for the upgrade to wire system, you don't need to learn the Cat5 cable, another cable. Just use the existing cable to connect to upgrade.
Without using like a RS-485 type?
Oh, no, that one just a whole wire.
Yeah. Right now, are you guys offering any packages, like a controller or a thing, an indoor and an outdoor, or is it all individually separate when you buy it?
How are right now, it's all separate. If there's a certain package that you buy a lot, you know, you can talk to your sales rep and he can put it together for you.
Yeah. Okay. How are those cameras, the door station cameras at night?
Well, they don't have infrared. We're waiting for a newer model that has infrared.
But it is coming eventually?
Yeah, it will. Okay. Yeah. We're waiting for that, and we're waiting for news about the Wi-Fi version of it, too.
So you want to have it in a decently lit area, is what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, exactly. Okay. That was the software. The software? Access control already in there, and intercom, and another free for the system compatible something. So also the intercom. Okay, you reset. See, you just connect the system here. And let me see the networking. And also the access control here, you just like the access control setting, let's just like the first car unlock, and mute unlock, anti-pass, and also the inter door lock. That means just like the two door controller, you need to all the doors close. And then unlock one door. So, and first car lock, just like if someone is the master car, need to swipe the car first, and another car swipe is available. If the car no swipe, everyone just waiting, cannot unlock the door. And also, our system is normally closed. That means if lose power. Like the emergent situation, that we will unlock all the door. Yeah.
But doesn't question. That pose a security threat for our own purpose?
I'm sorry.
If you have it normally closed, you lose power, then all the doors are open.
Yeah.
But isn't that a security threat? Let's say it's a business, nobody's there. Now the doors are open, everything can come in.
Actually, the normally closed is by the fire department. They request all the electric store like that normally closed. If
we usually we put the push bar. See that one there?
Yeah.
No, on that door.
Behind you. Oh, okay.
Yeah. So the lock has to remain locked, but if somebody's inside, they can push the bar and exit.
Yeah.
If you open the lock, it means anybody can get in.
But you know
if you use mag locks, yeah.
Yeah, if it's a mag lock, you cannot push.
Well, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yes.
You can also put your system on a UPS.
Yeah, put the system on a UPS, or just let the door you already has the lock here, and you have magnet. So, emergency, lost power, you just push open.
Right.
But if the power is normally open, that won't let you open the door. You push that one, still not open.
Well, yeah, because it's not a fire accident.
Yeah. Yeah, but the fire department need that normally closed. So if you lost power, you can use like the backup battery. Backup battery for the whole system. Let it work. That one backup battery for the access control system, just 12 volt. It's very simple. Like the alarm system.
I have a question. Yeah, could you import the user, users like using CSV?
Yeah.
Could
you if you already have the file,
yeah.
The user file, you just import it.
Yeah, usually what I do is have them on Excel sheets, and then as a month to month or week by week, you will get updated and just import it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You just import by file. You can select the file and import it. Excel, yeah. It's an Excel file. It's an Excel file. So it's
USB file.
No. Yeah.
Is that possible?
No, just two files. And CSV and then Excel.
Do you have a cut sheet on the controller?
I'm sorry,
on the door controller,
do
you have a cut sheet on
it? Yeah, before you leave today, give us your email. We'll email you over all the cut sheets.
Okay. That one's for the record. Someone open the door, we'll be show you the time, user ID, and the name. And also the car number, access control. That access control, that means if you connect access control, because maximum is 500 access controller, so that will show you which controller is the person. Is the person open the door? The door connect which controller? So you check everything, every record, and controller and the door. That means here is two door controller. So maybe two door one from controller one, or from controller two. And door 2, so that the record will check. And also the event description.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir.
I promise it'll be my last.
No, please. No, you know what? I encourage all you guys, ask as much as you want, please.
Well, you know, like some of the other systems that we do, the video integrates with the access control. So when they go in to look at their audit trail log, they can actually click on a picture of the person going through that door at that time for verification. Is that offered with this platform as well? Or is it going to be two separate functions where I can use the same software, but I got to go either into the video log to see it happen, but I got to go into the access log to watch the transaction happen on the clock?
These systems are set up to do a snapshot already when you hit it. So
that's already in the access version.
Yeah,
portion.
On the actual intercom part.
Okay.
So you can actually set it to, you can program it to that.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah. Also, you could set the EMAC, just like the map here.
Uh-huh.
Okay. The camera.
Oh, you can't integrate a map to it. Okay.
Yeah. You go to the mat, light the door. Where's
no
the door?
Up.
Where's
the
door?
Light up
yeah, where's the camera?
Gotcha.
Yeah. Light the door one is here. And door two.
That's perfect.
Yeah, door two is here.
Gotcha.
So, and also the camera. And also that one is for intercom. For the intercom system.
Oh, I got you.
Would you be able to show us something right now from another facility that you guys can access right now?
I don't believe we have any other, at the time, any other setups right now.
Like a live, like where we could see it working, where you could access it right now?
If you come to our office, we'll set it up for you. We'll be more than happy to do it and give you a full demo of it. But we don't have one, unfortunately, at this time. Sorry about that.
Do you think kind of a voice public, an alarm or enunciator or anything like that that like says, like for Microsoft and for Cisco, I did a lot of work for them in the Silicon Valley and corporate campuses, and they require a local door voice alarm. That if somebody stands there holding a door open to a lab too long, it triggers and it tells them, please close the door. You ever heard of anything like that?
Honestly, I don't know.
You can just put a local voice box tied onto one of these.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you can do that and then trigger through the alarm. Yeah.
Oh, also for the video, for the intercom system. That one's English, right? The language is English. But that one's support multiple English language. So you could put like the Spanish inside, another language to the outside auto unit to the intercom system. There will be multiple language for that. So not just like the English version.
The right kind of reader at the door.
Also for our access control system, you add the person. And the finger information. Some system need the user USB finger reader, right? But our system just set use the access control fingerprint here. The dot one and the reader one. And also correct. See, they will collect finger by the reader. No need to another device for the reader or for the card.
And all three of them, you could use them in the same location, like if on one room or one door you want to put that one, and the other doors you want to put the card reader?
Absolutely.
You can, right?
Yeah.
I know it's a dumb question, but...
No, there's no dumb questions. I really appreciate you guys asking as much.
Yeah.
How about face recognition?
These don't have that, but our new XVR recorders do have... It's not facial recognition, it's face detect. So there's two kinds of facial recognition is like a database, and usually those systems run you an arm and leg. With ours is face detect, so it detects a face, then it has a little side pane. You can choose what person you want to view, and then it'll show you a short video of what that person was doing. Now, if you want your facial recognition, we do have a enterprise level NVR that can handle that. And if you compare the price from that to the original facial recognition, it's a huge fraction of a price.
Yeah,
huge.
The temperatures of the skin.
Yeah.
So much involved in it.
Exactly. So we have both depending on your customer's budget.
On the fingerprint reader, using just enroll one record and that does it. I mean, you don't have to. Sometimes on the cradle, I know on some fingerprint readers, I've had to enroll the fingerprint in a couple of different records.
No, with this one, you just do it in one, and you can program it to unlock whatever door you want that fingerprint to unlock. It's kind of like having the RF card. You can program where you want, what access you want to grant that grab. Exactly. So once you put that fingerprint, it's like having an RF card, basically. You can program it anywhere. Yeah, it's pretty
customized.
Yes, definitely.
What do you guys provide as far as like tech support on your end? Like, is there like, Monday through Friday, between like work hours, or is it 24/7, or is it something where
Well,
you know, if I have questions about if I'm installing something and I have to ask you at 2 in the morning or something.
Well, usually depending on your sales rep, like for example, some of my customers, they will call me 2 in the morning.
But personally to you.
Yeah.
But I'm talking about like SavvyTech.
We just do business hours from 8:30 to 5:30,
right, okay.
Basically. Yeah.
So just get his cell phone number.
Yeah. That's what he's saying.
That's what I'm saying.
Get in his address.
Yeah, I call yours to chat in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
Yeah. How's it going now?
Definitely. Also, the thing I'm dealing with it.
What are you wearing?
The support up to 1500. 5,500 fingerprint. Yeah, keep it like that. And everything, every information, keep in the car, not computer. Computer just set up. Once set up, it's connect the computer. Everything in here.
In your car.
Yeah, in the controller. So no need to any server, any computer to keep the information, to keep track in every way, everything.
If you have one user that has two access methods, right? Fingerprint,
yep.
And a card, can you connect both of them to the same
individual? Yeah, actually it's the screen.
Okay.
Password, card reader, and the fingerprint.
And